is everyone today? Welcome to another episode of One Life Fully Lived. I'm your host, Jen Drakes, and I'm passionate about life and living it to the fullest. I'm going to take a little sidestep a bit for this episode because life never ceases to amaze me. It really doesn't. First of all, thank you to everyone who has checked out the podcast, supported me, sent me in their comments, talked to me about the show. I am encouraged by the amount of people that have just simply shown their support of me and this podcast. Truly, I am. And I want to look at something that amazes me. One thing about me is I have a strong voice, booming kind of, and it's been really great when speaking publicly because that has allowed me to project it quite far into a crowd. But for podcasting, that fact had kind of concerned me and was always in the back of my head. And early on, I had received some feedback related to my voice, being attentive to the pitch and all of this sort of thing. And in my typical fashion, I can honestly say I took that initial feedback perhaps too literal, and I seem to have ended up focusing on my vocal pitch and held back my enthusiasm and natural vibrancy, but so much so that it had, I believe, a negative impact on my delivery. And thank goodness for true and close and dear family and friends. And what's great is they know me extremely well. And they stepped in and provided like this really stark feedback that questioned what I was doing. Like they came at me like, you know, hey, what's going on? That's not you. So what are you doing? To hear that coming from those closest to you, it really lifted a weight from my shoulder. And it made me kind of shake myself up because we all listen to podcasts. We all listen to the radio. And one of the things that it's hard for us to fathom and we'd lose sight of is that doing that ain't easy. Doing this ain't easy. And, you know, for some of you listeners, and what did they, like, what advice did they give me? No, they did not ask me to pack up shop and run. Quite the opposite, in fact. They urged me to continue. But, yes, there was a but. And a big one. And I said, but. They asked me to be myself. To just go and do me. Do what I do. Which is, normally, I'm a very animated speaker. Very excited, loud, passionate. And I think I had a fear that would come across in some kind of very, you know, out there way. And it would be difficult for the audiences to hear me, but I think I went so extreme that I might have achieved the very thing I didn't want to have happen, because I thought by controlling my volume, I was helping you guys listen better. And instead, I think I did quite the opposite. And that's so far from what I intended. And frankly, at this point, trying to get that right groove, that right rhythm, that right flow, I'm no longer worried about that. I just want to do the very best job of engaging you, delivering impact, guiding and supporting you to make changes in your life. Changes that will allow you to live the best life you possibly can. And I'm committed to improve with each episode. So please be patient with me. Continue to listen. Give me a chance. Grow with me. I will improve. And just recognize it ain't easy. It really isn't. So now onto the real topic of the podcast. Today, I am speaking about imperfect tolerance. So to get to imperfect, I must first speak of perfect. So how many of you can honestly say you are a perfectionist? My hand is raised. You can't see it, but my hand is raised because I can. I didn't always consider myself to be a perfectionist, though. Really didn't. That realization only came after my child turned to me one day and said, pretty much in the only way children can deliver what they see, Mom, you are a perfectionist. And my reaction was gut reaction, right? It was no different like to getting burnt or paper cut. But instead of saying, ouch, I said, no, I'm not. Complete denial, right? my child looked at my, they looked at my body antics and you know, like they gave me this head shaken, neck pulled back look that really shouted, "You poor, poor, delusional person." And verbally they said, "You may not like to hear it, but you are." They were not backing down. So what did I do? I held off any more gut reactions, and I had become curious for why they were saying that. Like, what was making my child think I was a perfectionist? And here's what was even more surprising. For the young age that they were, they could clearly articulate their why, and they provided me with examples. I have to say, I was impressed. And what could I do at that point? But, you know, sit and think about it, reflect on this news. Because it was news to me. Now, that was many years ago. And since then, I have spent a lot of time looking at myself from the eyes of my child. And I got to the point where I could honestly say they were right. So I'm saying right now, I am a perfectionist. And in saying that, you get to understand then the earlier diversion of this podcast, the impact that has on me as a perfectionist. It is hard for me to settle with mediocrity. And in looking and reflecting on this, for those of you who have listened to the prior podcast, you remember I shared of having learned at a very early age that I would have to work for everything I wanted and needed. Well, I believe acceptance of that realization, along with some other, you know, truths like being female, really placed in me that my work ethics would have to be noticeably in the top. It would have to be of top quality. On top of that, going through this discovery of myself also made me realize that my mom was also a perfectionist. Being proud of your performance, any performance, job-related, extracurricular, and taking a pride of ownership of the things you do. Both me and my mom held ourselves accountable for high standards and would, in certain circumstances, expect the same from others. But that is what perfectionists do, for the most part. But the thing is, this is no simple topic. Perfectionism is a personality trait. And for me, it has its own spectrum that introduces the degree to which you apply the trait. Now, I'm no psychologist, and for sure, I'm not trying to come across as one. But in order to validate I need it, let me say that again. In order to validate I indeed had this trait, I had to first educate myself on what it was. Then I had to kind of become very conscious of what ways I was applying this behavior. With many traits, if not all of them, there's good and bad. And in the case of perfectionism, there's adaptive, which is good or healthy, and maladaptive, which is not so good and it's unhealthy. I'm getting into now a bit of the clinical side of it without being too clinical. So research suggests there are forms or types of perfectionism behavior. Psychologist Ewan and Fleck called out three. Self-oriented, other-oriented, and socially prescribed. There's other reports out there that go more granular and call out more types, but for the purposes of this podcast, I'm going to just stick to the three by Hewitt and Flett. Self-oriented perfectionists exhibit high performance standards. They yield high productivity. Essentially, they set high standards for themselves. No surprise that they tend to have career success. All the things I just listed are a walk-in billboard for that, right? Other-oriented perfectionists extend their high standards to others. So their tolerance for flawed work is very low, and hence they can be critical of others they consider to be living or operating below their high standards. And delegating is really hard for these other-oriented perfectionists. So it's no surprise they tend to have relationship challenges. And finally, there's socially prescribed perfectionists that have their sense of self-worth and value caught up in the expectation of others on themselves. And again, there's no surprise they tend to have anxiety and stress over being good enough. I actually consider now that my mom is a socially prescribed perfectionist. After I went through this and I realized, oh, my mom's a perfectionist. I'm a perfectionist. And just going through that whole journey, I believe my mom is a socially prescribed perfectionist. Now, I've never discussed it at this level with her. So as she listens to this podcast, she'd probably be surprised I said that. So I don't know if she would agree. But at the very least, we have both landed on the fact that she too is a perfectionist. Just not the type quite yet. And I may very well go back and have that discussion with her. So when I was unaware, I'm sure I leaned on the maladaptive side of the trait. But after becoming aware and in self-educating, I managed that side of my personality. I actually now believe everyone has the perfectionist trait, but it's all about where one places on the spectrum that's really important. Now, for some, the trait is more tuned than others. And with most things, I mean, moderation is key. I find that's with most things, right? Your diet, everything. It's all about moderation. And here's the thing. We are human beings. That's the bottom line. We are human beings. And as such, we are all imperfect beings. We make mistakes. So at this point in my life, I now consider the notion of perfectionism and perfection to be unrealistic. That does not change that I am a perfectionist. It really doesn't. But it does make me recognize that my behavior has to be managed and tuned for realistic expectations. So when I'm striving for success, working to my full potential, or setting high standards for myself, these are all good and fair goals. Commendable even. Now, we get back to another but, right? But all of that should be tempered with a dose of reality that considers other factors such as individualism for those other perfectionists. You have to look at the individual. You have to look at the surroundings. You may have to look at the tools available in whatever people are trying to do or you're trying to do, and circumstances. So, for example, some things are best done by trial and error, meaning it is sometimes better to start something than to hold off taking action, awaiting everything to come together perfectly. So if you're out there doing this, at least start. Try. For me, as a now adaptive, self-oriented perfectionist, I had to do the very same thing. I had to accept that my podcast would improve over time. My voice would get better. The content would become more polished. You know, the episodes would last longer. The artwork would improve. I would improve. But I had to start somewhere. I had to try based on imperfect tolerance. I had to try. With the notion that some things may be imperfect to start, and that I would have to practice and do it over and over again to get better and more comfortable with what I was doing. That does not mean I execute with low standards. Not at all. It doesn't mean that for any of us. But it does mean that we are open to any setbacks or mistakes occurring, and that we will embrace them. And we will set a continuous improvement mindset. And it's not always easy for perfectionists. So one example of a small setback is that my initial tapings were done in the wrong file format. I lost time figuring that out and getting them into the correct format. Another example is that my last podcast, Live Number 2 on Aladdin Carpets, was published with the volume too low. You know, people pointed that out to me. I had to correct it and republish it. That wasn't easy for me. I'm a perfectionist. But I didn't get angry at any of those two things. I just corrected it. And that will continue because this is a journey. Whatever you're trying to do is a journey. Whatever you want to do has to start with getting on to the journey, getting on to the road and trying. And being prepared that you'll have setbacks. Don't give up on the first setback, the second setback. Keep at it. Persistence. Perseverance. And in striving for anything, we must be prepared to manage the journey. But we also have to be prepared for the disruptions and imperfect aspects to intervene. If you're in charge of people and depending on where you are on the spectrum of perfectionism, see, I just had trouble saying the word. And if you are on the spectrum of perfectionism, imperfect tolerance may be more necessary than not to properly deal with the work performance of others and to effectively mentor them to improve where required, just as you get to improve where required. That's the beauty of life. That's the beauty of living life. We get to choose improvement. We get to choose our change, right? A large part of my career was spent in project delivery environments. Can you imagine a perfectionist in project delivery? If you have never tried to deliver a project, you may not understand, but for those who are project managers trying to deliver something, perfectionism, and certainly my perfectionism in that field, was an asset, but also a stressor until I learned to manage it. Learning to manage it, applying a flexible approach and imperfect tolerance made me a better leader and a better person. So now sitting here delivering this podcast as someone usually aware of perfectionism and what effect it can have on your life, positive or negative, I'm encouraging you to self-educate to determine its impact on your life. If you are on the unhealthy side of the trait, consider taking steps to shift to the healthy side, but give yourself the latitude for the change to occur. These things take time, and they should, in my opinion, never be viewed as healing. For me, it was and is about correcting behavior I wanted to change. My mom's behavior had an unconscious impact on me, and mine was having the same impact on my child. I wanted to change that, and I did all the work that was needed to manage it, to change that, to be more tolerant. I had to apply imperfect tolerance on myself. And if you're holding back doing something important to you, then consider that this trait may be at play. Don't be like me that didn't even think about it, that just kept doing and pushing, not realizing it was because of this trait. And please allow yourself the room for trial and error. Take action now towards achieving that goal. Get onto the journey that you need to be on, but learn to manage it. Know that not everything will or can be perfect. So allow for imperfect tolerance to kick in and minimize the fears and the stress associated with lofty standards. I'm happy to say that with education and awareness, I am no longer opposed to the behavior. And I don't want you guys to be opposed to the behavior because, as I said, I believe everybody has this. It's just degrees to which they apply it. And I just want it to be applied in a way that is healthy for me and those around me. And I want the same for you. Hopefully many of you listening also want the same. I am Jen Drakes. Thank you for listening. If you enjoyed this episode, follow the show. Please share the love and get ready for the next One Life Fully Lived episode.